हेलो गाइस, हेमरेज इन अर्ली प्रेगनेंसी एंड आल्सो वी विल सी अबाउट द अबॉर्शन एंड मिसकैरेज। कॉज ऑफ ब्लीडिंग इज अर्ली प्रेगनेंसी आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू ग्रुप्स, दोज रिलेटेड टू द प्रेगनेंट स्टेट, इट विल बी 95% एंड एसोसिएटेड विद द प्रेगनेंट स्टेट। तो दोज रिलेटेड टू द प्रेगनेंट स्टेट इट मे बी एक्टोपिक हाइड्रेटिव हार्मोन एंड इम्प्लांटेशन ब्लीडिंग and which associated with the pregnancy, this is due to the cervical lesions such as vascular ectopic erosion, polyp, rupture varicose vein and malignancy. We will see in gynecological lesion, it relation to the pregnancy, it may be fungal infection, fibroid, etc. which aggravate during pregnancy, this cause is known as associated with the pregnant state. Guys, myself Dr. P. Srivastava, and today we will discuss about the abortion and miscarriage. So, abortion is the expulsion and extraction from its mother of an embryo or fetus which weight is 500 gram or less than. It means it not capable to independent survival, right? According to WHO. So, the word miscarriage is the recommended terminology for the spontaneous abortion. Word miscarriage means spontaneous abortion, and abortus means the fetal weight is, it will be 500 gram or less than 500 gram, and attend at 22 weeks, it means 154 days of gestation, which expelled embryo is called abortus. Incidence, so miscarriage is 10 to 20% chances in all clinical pregnancy, and by illegally, it is at 10%. Weeks, before 8 weeks, it will be 75%, and before 16 weeks, also 75% chances to abortion. Now, we will come the point of the classification. Abortion is divided into two parts, spontaneous and induced. Spontaneous miscarriage and induced by the legally and illegal. Septic condition is the common through the illegal abortion. Now, spontaneous is divided into two parts, isolated means aspotic and recurrent. Aspotic means there is a history of the normal pregnancy, and second pregnancy it will be the chances of abortion. Okay, recurrent it means the abortion is continuing after every conception goes to abortion. This is called recurrent. Both are divided into threatened abortion, inevitable, complete, incomplete, missed and septic. Now, what is the etiology? So this is an obscure. The following factor, it may be chances to cause of abortion. First is the genetic cause. It may be 50% chances of miscarriage due to the chromosomal abnormalities in the conception, right? So in which we will see the autosomal trisomy. It is a commonest 50% chance of cytogenic abnormalities. Polypeptide has been the observed in about 22% endocrine metabolic. It is chances of 10 to 15% due to the LPD means luteal phase defect. Result in early miscarriage as implantation and placenta are not supported adequately. Okay, so LPD means luteal phase defect. It is luteinizing hormone is responsible for the ovulation, and when the defect, then it called be LPD, and this is lead to implantation and placentation are not supported adequately. Second is the thyroid abnormalities. Often thyroid abnormalities of hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism are associated with the increased fetal loss. Thyroid autoantibodies are often increased. Diabetes mellitus. It is a poorly controlled cause increased miscarriage. Anatomical abnormalities. It will be the 10 to 15% chances of. First one is the cervical uterine factor. These are related to the second trimester abortion. It may be chances of due to the cervical incompetency, a malformation of the uterus, okay, congenital malformation. This cause fetal loss due to the reduced intrauterine volume, reduced expansile property of the uterus, and reduced placental vascularity. increase uterine irritability and contractility, right? Uterine fibroid and intrauterine adhesion, it is a also a factor for the abortion. Now infection, it is a 5% chances of the infection due to the abortion in early stage of pregnancy. So this is the viral, parasitic and bacterial. Viral rubella, cytomegaly, variola, and viral rubella, cytomegaly, variola, vaccinia, yeah, HIV. In parasite, toxoplasma and malaria. So this is your common. And immunological factor, 5-10% chance of due to the APAS and autoimmunity. Okay, blood group incompatibility, maternal medical illness due to the cyanotic heart disease, hemoglobinopathies are associated with the early miscarriage. Thrombophilias, inherited thrombophilias, premature rupture of membrane. In environmental, we can see the lady which are taking cigarette smoking, a contraceptive agent, drug, chemicals, noxious, and chances of the fetus abort. And unexplained, 40 to 60% chances of which are unexplained, and it is indeed difficult in the majority to pinpoint the exact cause of miscarriage. Okay, now what is a common cause of the miscarriage? In two groups, first trimester and second trimester. In first trimester, it is a 50% chances of genetic factor, second endocrine due to the LPD, thyroid abnormality, diabetes, third one in immunological disorder due to the autoimmune and albumin, fourth infection, and fifth is unexplained. And second trimester we will see due to the anatomical abnormalities such as cervical incompetency, which may be congenital or acquired, Mullerian fusion, bicarinoid uterus, a septate uterus, uterine dysplasia, uterine fibroid, and maternal medical illness and unexplained. So unexplained is the common factor, 40-60% chances to miscarriage. Weeks. So in the early week, death of the ovum occurs first, followed by its expulsion, and later weeks, expulsion of the fetus, which may have sign of the life, but it too small to survive. Okay, 48 weeks, the ovum surrounded by the villi with the decidual covering and expelled out intact. Sometimes the external lobes fail to dilate, so that the entire mass is accommodated the dilated cervical canal, and is called cervical miscarriage. So this is the cervical miscarriage, right? Here is the internal external lobes. This is external lobes, internal lobes. So internal lobes, and this is the abortus, right? So the external was failed to dilate. This is failed to dilate, to expel out the entire mass. So it is accommodated in dilated cervical canal, and it is called cervical miscarriage. So this is the cervical miscarriage, right? 8 weeks and 14 weeks, expulsion of the fetus commonly occurs, leaving behind the placenta and the membrane, right? Beyond 14 weeks, the process of expulsion is similar to the mini level. Right. Threatened miscarriage. It is clinically where the process of miscarriage has started but has no progress to the state from which recovery is impossible. It means it recovery is possible, and we see the clinical features: bleeding per vagina and pain. Pain, it is a dull in nature and mild backache. Okay. During pelvic examination, it will be gently as possible. Okay. Now we will differentiate diagnosis to threatened miscarriage. So ectopy, polyp or carcinoma, ectopic pregnancy, and molar pregnancy. So this is also kept on mind for the differential diagnosis to differentiate the threatened miscarriage. Miscarriage has started but not progressed to state from which recovery is impossible, right? So we will see the threatened abortion. Here is the small bleeding from the placental side. It occurs and fetus remain in the uterus. Again, investigation of blood for the hemoglobin, hematocrit, ABO, and RH grouping. and anti D gamma globulin to be given Rh negative women. Ultrasonography, a well-formed gestation ring with cervical echoes from embryo indicated healthy fetus. Observation of the fetal cardiac motion, 98% chances of continuation of pregnancy, and brightened ovum is evidenced by the loss of definition of the gestational sac. Treatment, rest. The patient should be bed for a few days until bleeding stop, and prolonged restriction for activity has got no therapeutic values. Drug only for the or relief of pain. Diazepam 5 mg tablet twice a day. No. Advice and discharges. The patient should limit her activities for at least 2 weeks and avoid heavy work. Coitus avoided during this period. She should follow up with repeated sonography at 3 to 4 weeks time. Prognosis. The prognosis is very unpredictable, and in about 2/3 the pregnancy continued beyond 28 weeks, and in the rest it terminate either as inevitable or missed miscarriage. If the pregnancy it continues, there is increased frequency of preterm labor, placenta previa, intrauterine growth restriction of the fetus and fetal anomalies. Blighted ovum. What is a blighted ovum? It is a sonographic diagnosis. There is absence of fetal pole in gestational sac with diameter of 3 cm or more. This is known as bilateral. Inevitable miscarriage. It is a clinical type of abortion where the change has progressed to the state from where continuation of pregnancy is impossible. Clinical feature. Increased vaginal bleeding and pain aggravation, which may be colic in nature. Internal examination revealed dilated internal os. During internal examination, we can see the internal os is dilated and conception are felt. Management is aim to manage this case to accelerate the process of expulsion, because here is the pregnancy is impossible, and to maintain strict sepsis condition. To maintain strict sepsis condition. General measures. Excessive bleeding should be controlled by the administering methargine 0.2 mg if the cervix is dilated and size of the fetus is less than 12 weeks. Okay. And the blood loss is corrected by the intravenous IV fluid therapy and blood transfusion. Active management. Before 12 weeks. Okay. This is the less than 12 weeks. And before 12 weeks, dilation and evacuation followed by the curettage of the uterine cavity by using analysis set under general anesthesia, and alternatively suction evacuation followed by curettage is done. After 12 weeks, the uterine contraction is accelerated by oxytocin drip 10 unit in 500 ml of normal saline, and it will be 40 to 60 drops per minute. If the fetus is expelled and the placenta is retained, it is removed by ovum forceps. Okay. So if the placenta is not separate, digital separation followed by it evacuation is to be done under general anesthesia. Continuation of the pregnancy is possible in threatened abortion, right? Dilation of the external os so that abortus is expelled out and felt in external os, and it is impossible to continuation of pregnancy. And incomplete means some part of the abortus is remain in the uterus, so that it is a impossible to continuation of the pregnancy. So this is a type of the abortion, yeah, miscarriage. Now complete miscarriage. Complete means when the product of the conception are expelled in a mass, it is called complete miscarriage. And clinical feature, you will see the pain and bleeding, it is a common, and this abdominal pain is subsided when the complete miscarriage. Vaginal bleeding becomes stress absent. During internal examination, uterus is small than the period of amenorrhea, and cervical os is close, bleeding is stress, and when ultrasonography, TVS, uterine cavity is empty. This is a complete miscarriage. Evacuation of uterine curettage should be done if the uterine cavity did not empty with the help of transvaginal sonography. This is the type of management. And in Rh negative women without antibody, is her system should be protected by anti D gamma globulin 500 microgram, yeah, 100 microgram intramuscularly in case of early miscarriage yeah late miscarriage, okay, respectively within 72 hours. incomplete miscarriage. Incomplete means the entire product of conception are not expelled. Instead of a part of it is left inside the uterine cavity. It's called incomplete miscarriage. Okay, and this is a commonest type mating among us women. In clinical feature, we will find out the history of the expulsion of the fleshy mass per vagina, and followed by continuous of the pain in lower abdomen, persistence of vaginal bleeding, and internal examination reveals the size of the uterus is less than of amenorrhea, period of amenorrhea, and admitting tip of the finger in cervical os and varying amount of bleeding. Okay, on examination, the expelled mass is found incomplete. Ultrasonography, it is very important to find out the material to protect a conception within the cavity. Now, this is an incomplete miscarriage where the some part of the conception is remaining in uterine cavity. Complication: the retained product may cause profuse bleeding, sepsis condition, and placenta polyp. So now we will manage this case by the divide into two groups, recent cases and late cases. In recent cases, evacuation and retained product for conception, ERCP. ERCP means evacuation of the retained product of conception is done. She should be resuscitated before any active treatment is undertaken. Early abortion in an evacuation under analgesia or general anesthesia. In late cases, dilation and curettage operation is to be done to remove the bits of the tissue left behind the uterine cavity. So the removal material are subjected to the histological examination. It is very important for the incomplete miscarriage. Now, medical management: tablet misoprostol 200 microgram used vaginally every 4 hours. Missed miscarriage. Missed means when the fetus is dead and retained inside the uterus for a variable period, it is called missed miscarriage, early fetal demise. Pathology: the cause of prolonged retention of the death fetus is the uterus is not clear. In beyond 12 weeks, the retained fetus become macerated and mummified. The liquid amni gets absorbed and the placenta become pale, thin, and may be adherent. Before 12 weeks, the pathological process differ when the womb is more or less completely surrounded by the chorionic villi. So the womb become dead and either completely absorb or remain as a rudimentary structure. Gradually, the fluid portion of the blood surrounded the womb gets absorbed and wall become fleshy, hence the term fleshy canis. Clinical feature: the patient usually present with feature of threatened miscarriage and followed by the persistence of brownish vaginal discharge, subsidence of pregnancy symptoms, retrogression of breast changes, cessation of the uterine growth, which fact becomes small in size, non-audibility of the fetal heart sound, even the Doppler ultrasound if it been audible before, cervix fill form, immunological test for pregnancy become negative, ultrasonography it will be empty, and absence of fetal cardiac motion and fetal movement. Management: the case is managed by 3 process, expectant, medical, and surgical. Okay, so we will see in uterus is less than 12 weeks, then expectant management means any women expel the conceptus spontaneously, and medical management we will give in prostaglandin E1 means misoprostol 800 mg vaginally in the posterior fornix is given and repeated after 24 hours if needed. Okay, and expulsion usually occurs within 48 hours. Third, suction evacuation and dilation and evacuation. It can be done when the medical method fails. Otherwise, we can manage it by the expectant and medical. If the uterus is more than 12 weeks, induction is done by the following method. Prostaglandin are more effective than oxytocin in such cases. Then given prostaglandin E1 analog, misoprostol 200 microgram tablet inserted into the posterior vaginal fornix every 4 hours for maximum of 5 such, and to 20 unit of oxytocin in 500 ml of normal saline at 30 drops per minute is started. And many patients needed surgical evacuation following medical treatment Following medical treatment, ultrasonography should be done to document impetus uterine cavity. Surgery. Deletion and evacuation ducts of conception should be done. It means ERCP. Was an associated with the clinical evidence of infection of the uterus and its contents is called septic abortion. Although it is a criteria is where abortion is usually considered septic when there are having following symptoms. So septic means it is a chances of the illegal method of induced abortion is known as septic abortion. So in which we will see the clinical symptom rise of temperature at least 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit for 24 hours or more, offensive purulent vaginal discharges and other evidence of pelvic infection such as lower abdominal pain and tenderness. Now, mode of infection. So the microorganisms involved in the sepsis are usually those normally present in the vagina, known as endogenous. Are will be aerobic, anaerobic, and mixed. The anaerobic, it will be bactericidal group, fragilis, or anaerobic, streptococci, clostridium welsi, and tetanus bacilli. And aerobic, it will be ischemic coli, E. coli, Klebsiella bilia, staphylococcus, pseudomonas with group A, beta hemolytic streptococcus, methicillin, like that, okay? And mixed infection, it is a more common in case of the septic abortion, and the increased association of sepsis is unsafe induced abortion is due to the increased association of sepsis in unsafe induced abortion is due to the fact that are first one proper antiseptic and asepsis are not taken, second incomplete evacuation, and third is the inadvertent injury to the genital organs and adjacent structure, particularly the bowels. So this is a mode of infection, that's why the abortion may be septic. Clinical feature. Clinical feature, the women looks sick and anxious, temperature more than 38 degrees centigrade, tachypnea, increased respiratory rate more than 20 per minute, and having chill and rigors. It means suggest of bacteremia, abdominal pain, lower abdominal pain and chest pain also. Hypothermia, cardia, it is more than 90 due to the spreading infection. So during pelvic examination, we will find out the offensive purulent vaginal discharge, uterus filled tenderness, and it is a chances of the pelvic abscess. Clinical guiding. Because it is a septic in nature, so it must to take the clinical grading for the management of the case. So first, in first grade, the patient is looking anxious and infection is localized in the uterus. In second grade, the infection is spread beyond the uterus to the parametrium, tubes and ovaries or pelvic peritoneum. In third grade, it will be the generalized and cause general peritonitis and maybe endotoxic shock or jaundice or acute renal failure. This is a clinical grading. Investigation. First is the routine investigation, second is the special investigation. In routine investigation, we will take cervical or vaginal swab for the culture of aerobic and anaerobic media and test of the sensitivity of microorganism and for the antibiotics and a smear of gram stain. Blood, TLC, DLC, hemoglobin, ABO and RH grouping. And urine analysis. In special investigation, ultrasonography for the knowing the pelvic and abdominal retained product of conception, foreign body, it means having in intrauterine or intra-abdominal, free fluid in the peritoneal cavity or in pouch of Douglas due to the chances of the pelvic abscess. So this is a find out through the ultrasonography. Plain X-ray for the abdomen and for the chest. For the abdomen, in suspected case of bowel injury, and chest for the case of the pulmonary complication. Now, complication. So, there is a more chances of complication in grade 3rd, in which we will see the hemorrhage, spread of infection lead to genital peritonitis, and this infection reach into the uterine tube, perforation of the uterus, and cause bursting of the micro abscess in the uterine wall, and injury to the gut. It may be chances of endotoxin shock due to the E. coli or Clostridium welsi infection. it may be chances of, it also chances of acute renal failure due to the necrosis of tubule due to the Coxsackie villi, okay, and thrombophlebitis. So this is the chances of the complication we will see in third grade up. Remote, the remote complication include chronic debility, chronic pelvic pain and backache, dyspareunia, ectopic pregnancy, secondary infertility due to the tubal blockage and emotional depression. So this is a complication. Now prevention. So we will boost up family planning to acceptance in order to unwanted pregnancy so that illegally abortion is not taken by the family. Rigid enforcement for legally abortion in practice and prevalence of unsafe abortion. So can through the education and through the motivation. To take antiseptic and aseptic precaution either during internal examination and during operation in a spontaneous abortion. This is a prevention. And now general management. To management, we will first of all, in general management, patient is hospitalized all cases of septic abortion, and to take high vaginal cervical swab for the culture and sensitivity test, vaginal examination and assessment of the cases for the clinical grading and investigation. So what is the principle of management? The principle of management is for the to control sepsis condition, to remove the sources of infection, and to give supportive therapy to bring back normal hemostasis and cellular metabolism, and to assess the response of treatment. It is an important part of the management. Okay, now we will see in grade first. So here is the treatment in grade first. First of all, drug, antibiotics, prophylactic anti-gas gangrene serum. It will be 8,000 unit and 3,000 unit of anti-tetanus serum intramuscularly given if there is a history of intervention. Right? And analgesics and sedative if required. Blood transfusion is given to improve anemia and body resistance. So, evacuation of the uterus. An abortion is often incomplete because it is a type of the incomplete abortion, so that evacuation should be performed at the convincing time within 24 hours following antibiotic therapy. And if the excessive bleeding is so, urgent indication for the evacuation. Right. Second grade drug, antibiotics. Mixed infection include gram-positive, gram-negative and anaerobic, aerobic organism are common. So ideal antibiotic regimen should cover all of them. So in clinical monitoring, to note pulse, respiration, temperature, urinary output and progress of the pain, tenderness and mass in lower abdomen, and CVP greater than 8 mmHg. It is a very important for the clinical monitoring in sepsis condition, right? So first is the evacuation of the uterus. Evacuation should be withheld for the at least 48 hours when the infection is controlled and is localized. The only exception being is excessive bleeding, right? Second is the posterior colectomy. When the infection is localized in the pouch of Douglas and pelvic abscess is formed, then it can be posterior colectomy. And drainage of the pus relieve the symptom and improve the general outlook of the patient. So, third grade. Antibiotic, also discussed above. So, supportive therapy is directed to treat generalized peritonitis by gastric suction and intravenous crystalloid infusion. Feature of organ dysfunction such as carefully monitoring, and patient may need intensive care unit management, right? Now, active surgery. Indication for the active surgery: when injury to the uterus, suspended injury to bowel, a presence of foreign body in the abdomen as evidenced by the sonography and x-ray, and unresponsive peritonitis suggestive of collection of pus, and septic shock, oligomania not response to the laparotomy should be done by the experienced surgeon with a skilled anesthetist. Removal of the uterus should be done irrespective of the priority, right? Keep it in mind for the septic abortion and advise and motivate the patient to take a safe and legal abortion, and also encourage the family planning.